Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. This is episode 960 for February 27, 2009. I'm going to be out at Microsoft on Monday taking a look at the new Excel 2010. So, hey, here's an invitation. If anyone has any complaints, suggestions, tips, or anything like that, drop me a note, bill@MrExcel.com, and I can get those directly out to the product design team, the folks that design Excel. Of course, all the features for Excel 2010 are already locked down, but soon they're going to start to think about the next version of Excel that'll come out in a couple of years, so I'll be happy to pass those on. I have a great tip today sent in by Paul Leonard. Paul is talking about a feature that actually started in Excel 2003. If you would edit a cell that has a function, for example, this cell, and you click inside the function, interesting thing happens. The tooltip appears. Now, the tooltip sometimes gets in the way. You can't see the adjacent cells. And if this formula had been pointing down to the row below, it would be very annoying. Well, Microsoft thought of this, and you can actually go to the edge of that tooltip and drag the tooltip somewhere else. Very cool to get that out of the way. Another thing that's great with this tooltip is if you need to figure out how something is working, hover over the function name, and it is a great way to get to help for that function. All right, so someone sends you a worksheet, can't quite figure out how the formula is working, you can get to help very quickly. Just basically press F2, click inside the function name, and then click on the function name in the tooltip, and you'll get directly to help for that particular function. Great tip from Paul. So, if you have any things that are just driving you crazy about Excel, drop me a note, and I'll be with the folks next week who can actually do something about it. Now, of course, you're saying, well, hey, what are you going to be able to tell us about Excel 2010? And everything's under non-disclosure, so we're going to have to come up with some sort of a code system. Maybe if I start winking with my right eye, it means they're getting rid of the ribbon and bringing back the old menus. All right, that's the code. Anyway, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.